Our seventh episode, Chapter 7, is about a rule that is brand new to Next Level, Rule G17. Rule G17 reads as follows. Robots may not directly or indirectly lift or hold more than one hub off of the floor at a time. Pushing, shoving, pulling, or plowing multiple hubs along the floor, field perimeter, or field elements is not considered a violation as long as these hubs remain in contact with the floor. However, if a robot controls multiple hubs that are not in contact with the floor, such as pushing a hub with two hubs stacked on top of it, this would be a violation. Minor, momentary, or incidental violations of this rule that do not affect the match will result in a warning. Score-affecting offenses will result in a disqualification. Teams that receive multiple warnings may also receive a disqualification at the head referee's discretion. This rule is actually more of a robot design rule than a gameplay rule. That is, if you're creating a mechanism which can lift hubs off of the floor, make sure they can only do so one hub at a time. If you design your robot to only lift one hub at a time, you will probably not violate this rule. Note that the barriers and the blue terrain pieces are considered to be part of the floor. So, if you're pushing hubs across the field and a few of them bounce up momentarily, this is fine. Note that this rule also specifically allows manipulation of multiple hubs at once, so long as they remain in contact with the floor. You could even have one hub lifted in the air if you want while doing this, but only one. Indirect control still counts as control as well. Again, the key thing to remember in this rule is how many hubs are not in contact with the ground. Whether there is support, possession, or any other terms common in VRC, it does not matter. As with all rules in the VEXIQ challenge, referees should provide verbal warnings early and often if a team is close to violating this rule. The most severe form of violation would be holding multiple hubs off of the ground and scoring them into the building zone. This would be considered a score-affecting violation and would result in a disqualification. However, in most matches, this should not be a problem. If you do have an advanced robot design with the capability to bring this rule into question, you can help referees by making it abundantly clear that you are abiding by the rule. That's all for Chapter 7, but make sure you check out our other videos in this series, and don't forget that the VEXIQ Challenge Game Manual is your best friend.